PTC surprised a lot of people this morning, March 19th, 2019, when all of a sudden they sent out an email to people and said, hey, Creo Parametric 6.0 is available for download. So if you want to get the latest and greatest, be sure to go to ptc.com, access your account, and you need to up-rev or rev up your licenses. Then you'll be able to download Creo Parametric 6.0 and start using it. So in this video, I'm just going to show you a few of the things I've noticed. I've only been playing around with it for a few minutes now. First off, you'll notice that the skin and look of the interface is a little different. They tweaked the color scheme again, and the shapes of the tabs and the icons and groups are a little different. They've also changed which icons are available. So for example, I noticed that there is a model check group on the model tab in assembly mode. All right, let's start making some changes. So first off, let's say that I have a subassembly here. You notice right when I click on the subassembly and expand it, we are going to get this little line here that shows where we are actually working in the model. So that is new, different than the insert here arrow. And I'm gonna click on a component and then activate it. And what you'll notice is that the components get dimmed in the graphics area. They added that a few versions ago, but now it also dims the model tree so you can see where exactly you are working in terms of the different levels inside of here. Let's get out of that. I'm just going to do Control A like normal to deactivate, and the model tree goes back to the way that it was. Next, I'll show you a minor change that they made to inheritance features. I'm going to create a brand new part. I'm not going to change the name. And I'm going to create an inheritance feature as normal. So I will go to the Get Data menu and choose Merge / Inheritance. Let me grab the file that I want to use. Let's grab this part over here. And for locating it, I'm just going to use the default constraint. Nothing here right now, and there's actually nothing new in the creation, except I will point out that if you take a look in the upper right-hand corner of the dashboard, we have additional help that's being given to us in order to help create the features. And if you click on Read More, it's going to take you to help for Creo Parametric. And you'll notice that the shapes of some of the icons on here are different. But let's make this an inheritance feature, and let's go to the options, varied items, and for the different dimensions, I'm just going to pick a few of the different features in here. Let's have that diameter. Let's grab this diameter over here. Oops, didn't get it. That diameter over there, and plug in some new values. And from the Features tab, let's just select a couple features that we will suppress. So again, nothing new here. I'm just creating an inheritance feature. And just to show you that when you right-click on the inheritance feature in the model tree, you can get to varied items right from there. You don't have to go to Edit Definition and then Options tab. You can get right to varied items from the right mouse button menu. Okay, speaking of which, let's take a look at right mouse button menu. And so here I've got a part over here, and I'm going to activate this. And I'm going to create an extrude. Like I mentioned before, when you get into a command over on the right-hand side of the dashboard, you're going to get some additional information that's guiding you, plus the hyperlink that will allow you to get additional help. But if you take a look at the dashboard, they've tried to remove ambiguity in terms of what the different buttons and icons mean. So most of these are stacked in two rows, and also it tells you what the icon does rather than you having to hover your mouse over the model. But anyhow, I'm just going to go in here and sketch on the surface for the references. Let me just grab a couple other references in here just to make sure that I am fully placed. And for my sketch, Really don't care what I am going to create. Let's grab from the palette the rounded rectangle. And just drag it. Oops, that's the rotation. That's good. Really, again, I don't care what I'm creating. I'm just trying to create something. And now we've got this sketch extruded to a distance. And I'm going to hit the middle mouse button just to show you that now when you select a feature and go into edit definition and then select stuff inside of here, you're going to get many toolbars. And if I hold down the right mouse button, here we get a right mouse button menu. But the big thing is when you are in edit definition, you are going to get additional mini toolbars. If I want to change this solid to surface, turn this into a cut, thicken the feature, add taper on here. So mini toolbars added to edit definition of your features is brand new in Creo Parametric 6.0. So that again, just a few enhancements wanted to show you that Creo Parametric 6.0 is available and some of the enhancements to assembly mode and fundamentals, and more videos will be coming. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more information, please visit www.creowindchill.com. If you learned something from this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you like this video, please click the subscribe button to be informed when new videos are uploaded. Thank you very much.